This conference will now be recorded.
Hi everyone, this is Rohit Kumar. Today I am here to discuss about ServiceNow and Salesforce integration. ServiceNow and Salesforce both are the cloud platform, you know, and both the platform maintain some their data. So today I am here to tell you how we can integrate between ServiceNow and Salesforce. So let's see how you can get your ServiceNow instance and how you can get that Salesforce, and then we'll discuss further. To get your ServiceNow integration, ServiceNow instance, you have to visit developers.servicenow.com and you have to register and get the instance. And to get the Salesforce instance, you have to visit the developer.salesforce.com and click the sign up. And this is the sign up page. You have to fill all the information and you will get those instance. So I have already signed up for ServiceNow and for Salesforce. So make sure that you sign up for the developer edition from the Salesforce and from the ServiceNow. So let's see. This is my ServiceNow instance and this is my Salesforce instance. So I am going to connect between those two instances through the REST API. To connect this Salesforce instance, first you have to create some connector and then you have to connect between those two instances. So this is Salesforce instance. You go to the settings, click the setup. It will open a setup page from where you have to set up. So from there, you have to, in the left navigation, you can see that this is the apps module. In the apps, if you go to the app manager, you have to see the app manager. And from there, you have to create a new app. So let's create a new app, new connected app in the right side. So once you create the app, through that app, we will connect ServiceNow and to the Salesforce. So I am putting that name. So before that, connecting to the ServiceNow and Salesforce, I want to check with my Postman instance how we can validate those things. So first I will connect those through the Postman and then again, I will create a Salesforce application. All right, so let's first create the Postman to application. And I am putting that any of this email, abc@gmail.com. And once that is done, you have to click enable OAuth setting. Click that and here is the callback URL that you need to be provided. So what is the callback URL? So after you authenticate all those things, so first of all, you have to understand that Salesforce use that OAuth 2.0. Using that OAuth 2.0, we are going to connect this Salesforce application through this app module Postman and we'll integrate between those two. So for that, you have to provide the callback URL. So let's go to the Postman first. So I'll choose that the OAuth 2.0 is the authentication type and click the get new authentication token. In the top, you can see that callback URL. So this is the callback URL. You have to copy here from here and paste to this application callback URL. So once your callback URL is done, this is all the scope that you can add it. So I'm choosing all the scope and moving here. So I need all the scope details and hit save. So once you create the application, we'll see that application details. So this is the application Postman 2. It's generate that a consumer key or we can say that public key, another is the consumer secret or the secret key. These two things are generated, and in the right side you can see that the callback URL. So let's see how we can get that details first in the Postman, how we can get that token, and then that token we can use that. Okay, so if we go to the Postman, I'm putting that token name is this OAuth URL that you need to be provide here. So let's back go to my documentation. So if you see, this is the developer, this is the link. I'll definitely post it in that my description box, but if this is the link where all the endpoint OAuth related endpoint are present. So let me open that one. Okay, so you can see this OAuth endpoints is that the page where all the endpoint details are present. So in this case, authorized URL and the access token URL we have to provide. So authorized URL is nothing but a URL from there the user can authorize their details. So this is the authorized URL. We are going to copy here and paste this to the token URL here, and this is the token URL. We are going to copy this token URL and put here, and now we have to put the client ID and the client secret. Go to this client ID and client secret. To get that, go to the manage app. This is the client ID. I'm putting here and checking is there any spaces or not, and the client secret I have to go here, click that, and from there I can receive my, let's zoom out little bit, and from there I'm going to copy this one and paste it here. Go back to this one, is it? So once we put this information, this will be the authorization code. Once these informations are done, we'll click the request token. It will be give us the token. So let's see, if you go to, this is the developer's REST API helper where all these things are mentioned. So to integrate between Salesforce to the ServiceNow or any other application, they use the authorization. So authorization is nothing but a token. To connect app, we use that OAuth 2.0, and from there we can use our some integration. Okay, so first we put that information, and if we click the request token, it will be generate a token. That token can be used in your header. So see, this pop-up is open. Once you click the request access and click the allow, so it will add to that token to our Postman. We'll see that. So you can see this is the token name generated here, and we got that access token. This is the access token we received that, and here is the option use as a header or URL, right? So first of all, our first job is to create an application here into the Salesforce, and then put the callback URL, and once you create that, it will generate that consumer key and consumer secret. Go to this Postman application, and from there You can choose the authentication type is 2.0, get the access token option, click and click the request token. And so once you provide your credential, you will be received that token. So first job is done. So first of all, why I'm using this Postman? Because from the Postman, we can test that any of this integration application. So first I'm checking the Postman, and then I'll come to the ServiceNow point and we'll set up the same configuration to ServiceNow. So this one is done. The token generation is done. Now we have to call the REST API. To call the REST API, there are several options are there for REST API. This is the REST API developer guide. If I scroll down, there must be that working with the data so that we can create some data, update some data, or delete some data. So if I click the create a data, so they are saying this is the URL you have to call and this is the data you have to pass so that you can create one account through the integration, not by manually going to that ServiceNow, that in the Salesforce. So if I scroll down, I can see this one. So click in this script part and this is your URL, copy that URL and go to this Postman tools. Definitely the method will be the post method. Put your instance ID. So our case, the instance ID we are using actually that app 16. Copy that one. Okay. And now we have to parse some body into that request. If you see, this is your URL and this is the sample body we need to pass during this integration. So let's copy this body and go to this Postman. In the body, you can click the raw, set the JSON and use that one. Along with that, you can see that we received the authorization token that we have not used yet. Because if you go to the header, it's only the contact type is application/json. So we have to use that token also. So first you add the token options. It should be header and click the use token. And you can see that header is increases and the token is added here. Now, if we send the data, it should create one accounts into the Salesforce instance. So let's visit that first Salesforce instance and see, is there any accounts present to the Salesforce or not? So if this is the accounts record, if we click that account, there is no account details present. So instead of creating this new in the manually, if you trigger this integration, it should create one data or one record to here. So let's send that data. Once I send the data, you can see it's generate one ID and the success equal to true and error is blank. It means that it's generate one account. Let's refresh the Salesforce and see. So you can see one Express Logistics and Transport, this account is created through this APA because we are passing that information as a body. That information is created through this Postman, through this Salesforce instance. So similarly, same integration will perform not only through this. Definitely from this Postman, we create the details from the ServiceNow. So let's go back to that ServiceNow and we will do that all those steps. So first task again, we have to create one application or else we can manage that, we can change that application name and create those steps, but I am more creating a new application. So click the new connector app. Put that snow is that details abc@gmail.com and click that enable OAuth 2. So callback URL, we have to provide the callback URL. For callback, if you visit my documentation, this is the callback for ServiceNow. Copy this one and paste here. Check your instance ID 95057 is the callback URL, and then you have to choose all this scope and move there. Once that is done, you have to choose that save options so that it can create one application. So our application is done to that for the ServiceNow. The Snow application is ready. So from there, we can start accessing those information. Okay. So let's go to that ServiceNow instance. I logged out somehow. Okay, now in this ServiceNow instance, you have to first generate one like that authentication token we generated for the Postman. Similarly, we have to generate that for, we have to type OAuth in the left navigation, click the application registry, click the new. And there is three options available. So you have to, you are going to connect a third party application. So choose the connect to a third party. Here you have to put all your details. So let's put the sales. Client ID you have to provide. So client ID is nothing but it's just generated for this application. You have to copy this one. And the client secret, you have to put that, which is nothing but this token. Okay, now once those things are done, I'll make that reset. Okay, once those things are done, you have to choose this default grant type as a authorization code, and here you have to provide some authorization URL, token URL, revocation URL, and redirect URL. We'll put one by one. So first, if you go to this article regarding token URL, so this is the authorized URL, copy this one and paste here. This is the token URL, you have to copy this token URL and paste here. Similarly, if you click the revoke URL, copy that and revocation URL, and this is the redirect URL. That redirect URL is nothing but this is the redirect URL. So ServiceNow, put those stuffs, log those informations, and that's it. You have to save that record. Once you save that, you can see that sales default profile is created. So we have to define the scope here. So scope is what? Scope is nothing but if you go to the manager, these are the scope. So we have to copy these all the scope and define here. So ID. API. Okay, so next thing is that pull, these are the scope through that they can access the application. Okay, next thing is that okay. So those scope name also defined here. You can go to this OAuth token and scope, and you can find the scope name and what is the purpose of every scope. If I scroll down, you can see that API. Okay, so these are the scope name here. You can use those. So I am just copying and pasting those on refresh token. Okay, now open ID. Next thing is that custom permissions. Then web API. Okay. So these are the entirely it's done. Scope define is done. Now, if you go to these profiles, you can see that there is a one field called sales default profile. You have to include all those scope to that profile. So let's see. I just press that control and click on that so that it can open in the new tab, and I can add all these scope one by one. Okay. So here we have to define all this stuff. So first is API. It's taking some time. So API, next is refresh token. Custom permission. Somehow it's not coming. Three open ID. So see, you have to choose the sales one because we created that profile as a sales. And we so API we added full. We have to add the full. And then we have to Visual Force. And we have to click that Web API. Okay, so now if we go to the application registry, go to the cells. So these are all the informations we provided here, and these are all the application scope we defined here. And the profile, if you go to the profile, sales people profile, these are the scope we also defined here. Okay, now go to this REST message. We are going to actually connect that. So go to the REST message, create a new REST message. And here you have to provide the endpoint. So endpoint is nothing but this one is that we previously got that endpoint. We can use that endpoint for account creation. So click here, and this is the endpoint. Copy this one and paste here. This is the app16 is your instance ID. Put that one. And authorization, choose the basic. Put the cells. No, so basic OAuth 0.2 cells. It should be sales, not the sales force. Sales default. Okay. And submit. So once you save that, it will be okay. Save that. So if you can see on the top, it says that OAuth access or refresh token are not available. Verify that configuration, get the auth token. So this is the profile we set it. Now, along with that, it by default generated on get method here in the below. Click that get OAuth token here, and it will be came as a Salesforce application. You just click to allow access so that you can get the token. Token is now generated. And you can see that it will be refreshed at this time. Now, if I open this method, here we have to define the method. Previously, if you remember, we put the post method. So click the post method. And in the request type, go to the request type. Here is the content that you have to pass. The content is nothing but this is the content. You have to copy here and put that content here. I'm putting that name as a new this one and click the save button. So once that is done, you can click the test button to test that it's working or not. Once you click the test, it will hit to that Salesforce, and we are getting that one missing content type, invalid content type. So we have to pass that content type as a header. So let's put that content type as a header. So if we go to the here, we have to pass this content type. And the value should be application slash JSON. We have to pass this one. Once you save that, so if we go here, right now we have one account. Now if we hit the test, it should generate another data to that account table. So let's see. It is generated with the success code, and if we refresh this page, you will be able to see the another account details. So let's refresh. Say new service logistics transport. This is the created. Now, if you think that this REST message should be triggered once that any user is created, then to the automate this process, so what you can do, you have to create a business rule so that it can trigger something during this user creation. I'm creating on business rule. On the CS user table, create account on Salesforce. Okay, it's taking some time. Click the advance, insert, after, advance. We have to write some code so that it can trigger to that. Okay, it should trigger. So go to the REST message again. Here, and this is our REST message. So instead of that, we have to put some dummy value here so that for that, click here, save that, and click right click on the top, click the auto generate variables. It will be generate one variables in the bottom, name, and click the preview script uses. We will be able to find that full code for that. Copy that code from here and paste it in your business rule. So if you can see the name we are passing, instead of the blank, you are going to pass that current dot this first underscore name. Plus putting some concatenation and current dot last underscore name. dot toString. Similarly for this one, dot toString. So it will trigger that one, and it will create once that business rule will trigger. After this, we should choose the table name. User once you save that, the business rule is ready. Now if I go back and create one user with some details, snow user, let's spend some time. Okay, it's ready. Okay, the script is ready. If I hit save, it should generate one account to that Salesforce through this integration. So it is created, one user profile is created, and if we go here and refresh, hit refresh, it should generate one new account that is called Snow User. Let's see. See, it's created one user, but undefined user. Maybe that code we provide. See that there is a spelling mistake name. So we'll save that once more time and go back and create a new account called new snow account. So it is corrected, and if we save that, it should create one more profile to that account. So let me refresh this one. So you can see the new snow account is created here, and you can see the details, and this is the ID of this account. We don't provide any other informations, but yeah, so we can update that. So if you go to this REST API, there are various options here. You can see you can update that any record, you can delete the record, you can get some data from here. So all those things you will be able to find from there. The code also there, that endpoint and all those stuffs are there. So you just need to create the application and connect those applications. Okay. Thank you very much for joining this call. Have a good day.